Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to showcase the Shopify URL redirects functionality, the built-in one. This video will not showcase advanced apps for it, but I'm going to show you what's built in. So what are URL redirects? URL redirects are a feature that the business owner can specify that they want the customer to redirect from one URL to the other. So why would you need something like that? So let's say, for example, I'll give you a few examples. Number one is, let's say you prior did not have a Shopify site. You had a different site, like a Magento site or a WooCommerce site or some other site. And your URL structures of your specific pages, like your collection pages or certain product pages or certain about pages, they're different. They're different URLs. So you might have had, for example, website, let's say mintstory.com/, let's just say contact. And then in Shopify, the actual URL is something like /pages/contact us, right? So you want to make sure that there's a consistency between the pages. So on the old site, people knew the URL contact us, the search engines knew the URL, and now you have a new site and you just transferred, and you want to match those pages. You don't want people to click on the wrong page and get a 404, get a missing page, and then try to figure out how to get to the contact page. So you want to basically bridge that gap. So you want to redirect from one to the other. So this is good for site migration. So if you re-platformed, you change from one site to the other. It's good in some cases if you maybe had a very popular collection page or a product page and you decided to delete it or disable it, and you wanted to redirect customers, if they ever get to that page, from one page to, let's say, the newly made one or some other alternative page. And then the last reason you want to do that is also for search engines. So search engines typically want to make sure that customers can find the pages correctly. If you do not have that page anymore, you want to redirect it. And you want to do a 301 redirect, which is a permanent redirect, which is what this does. Okay, so you're basically saying whatever page existed before that I tell you, I do not want customers to go there. I want them to permanently go to this new URL. Okay, so let's talk about how you do this stuff. So I'm going to give you an example. Okay, number one, you log in the back end and you click on online store and you go to navigation. So when you click on that, you go to the navigation. This is where you manage your menus. But right here, there's a URL redirects button. So what I do is I click on it, and I made an example for this video, and I'm going to show you what you can do. So first of all, you can create them one by one. So create a URL, and you're going to specify the original address, and then where you want it to redirect to. So in the case of example, if you remember their example, let's say I had an old site and my site was called, slash contact, my domain slash contact. So I can actually do here, I don't need the domain, I just need the first starting slash. And then I want to redirect it to, for example, this slash pages. So I can specify in the redirect to the whole URL, or I can just keep the first slash after the domain, something like that. I typically like to do this. You can do different ones. Okay. So that's it. I click on save. Okay. And now I can go back to my view redirect. So now if someone goes to my page, for example, if you remember slash contact, that was the old URL. If I click here, I got redirected. You see the URL changed very quickly. It is a 301 redirect, which is really good. And if you refresh the page, that redirect should be in your list right here. Okay. The reason it's not in the list right now, I've noticed that it takes Shopify usually about a minute or so to put it in the list. So you just have to wait patiently. But obviously you saw the redirect work. So I'm going to show you one more method you can do. And then once we refresh next time, it should be here. The other thing is, so this button allows you to create URL redirects one by one by one by one, right? Now, in some cases, especially if you transfer platforms, you might have 500, 100, 1,000, et cetera. So you don't want to start going one by one and making mistakes. So what can you do? You can actually go and you can import them. You can go to make a spreadsheet and do it. So how do you do that? So first of all, you're going to click on import right here, okay? And then what you're going to do is you're going to download the CSV, so you keep the same exact format. So once you click it, it downloads. I already prepared for the video, so I basically put it right here. And if you notice here, the structure is really, really simple. So you're not going to touch these. Redirect from and then redirect to, don't touch it. And then the same thing that we did right here, There's a field for from and to, and what you're going to do, you're going to put it here. So for example, if I want to redirect slash about dash us to slash about, I would just do that, and that's it. And you're just adding one by one. Okay, so slash, I made a mistake here. Okay, slash, sale to, for example, slash sale 2020, right? You're just going to do that. And then what you do is you do download as a CSV, download a CSV. You go back here to the import, and you choose from your computer. Okay, this one, and you upload the file. Okay, so now you have some information here. So your import contains three redirects. Here's some previews, and then you click on this. So it'll show you if there's some error, some issue. It'll show you some detail here. So you have a summary, you confirm it, and it's in process. So now it's complete, and I can go back to my redirects. Now you see I have the contact one right here that we made before, and now we'll have to wait about a minute or so for the other ones. But you don't need to wait for that. Obviously, it'll work for you. So if you have any questions, let me know. I hope you enjoyed the video. And in future, we'll make some videos with redirects for using advanced apps and kind of go from there. So again, appreciate it. Thank you very much.